Hi everyone, and welcome back to my first video of 2022. What the heck? How is it 2022? What's going on? I don't know. I wanted to make just a quick little 2021 wrap-up video and talk about the good, the bad, the ugly that happened this past year, and then also kind of blend into some of my goals for 2022. So first off, 2021 was a really tough year for a lot of people. I think probably everyone, myself included. This year was really hard. Some of the scariest, most difficult things happened in my life this year. And despite it all, there was still so many amazing things that happened. So I just kind of want to like talk about all those things in a little bit of detail. Some of them I won't go into detail, but yeah, I just want to talk about it all. Just want to take a moment to kind of reflect on everything. It's kind of like therapy, but cheaper. And yeah, then we'll move into 2022. Okay, so first off, let's start with the bad so that we can get it done and over with and then move on to the good stuff. So yeah, the bad that happened this year, I think the most obvious thing would be COVID is still around, still wreaking havoc. Is it wreaking or wrecking? There's havoc. Yeah, jokes aside, I think we all really thought that this was going to be hopefully gone by now. And it's not. It's still here. So that sucks. And now moving into 2022 with Omicron and all the horrors that are coming with that, it's really freaking scary. So yeah, 2021, COVID was still rampant and horrible and awful. I think for a lot of people, COVID has just been this big dark cloud kind of looming over them, and it's made a lot of things harder. So that definitely sucked in 2021. The second thing is very personal to me and my family, but this year in 2021, my partner, my boyfriend of five and a half years, he got diagnosed with MS, which is not something that I've spoken about on YouTube at all yet, but that was and is a very terrifying thing that's happening in my life right now, and in his life, and in the lives of everybody who loves us. That really made 2021, I think, the hardest year that I've had. So yeah, my boyfriend's health has been not great. He's been sick for a long time, off and on, and it was just kind of a battle of trying to figure out what was making him sick. And then this summer, 2021, the summer of 2021, things seemed to be getting really good and he was quite healthy, and then it just all changed really quickly. He started getting numbness in different parts of his body, and shortly after he was diagnosed with MS. So that has been a big struggle in 2021 for sure. On a more positive note, he's on medication right now and he's doing pretty good. I don't want to talk too much more about that in this video, but hopefully I can give you guys an update on that soon. I guess the last like negative thing of 2021, big negative thing, was just this overall feeling of uncertainty in my life, in the world, in what I'm doing. I had a lot of doubts in myself this year because I took a lot of big chances on myself, which is exciting, but also very terrifying. So every time there was a peak, there was also a valley where I just had so much self-doubt and so much fear. And yeah, that's something that definitely has plagued me a lot. So we're done with the bad. Let's move on to the good. Okay, let's talk about the good in 2020. I think the first good thing that happened this year, okay, well, not the first good thing, but the biggest notable good thing that happened was me in July making the decision to go completely self-employed. And it was really scary. I haven't talked too much about it on YouTube, I don't think, but I talked about it more on my Patreon. All of my game development contracts, because I was a freelancer for a while, came to an end at the same time. And it wasn't planned. It wasn't something that I felt ready for at all. But it happened, and I saw the opportunity, and I decided to just go self-employed, and it was terrifying and exciting. And I'm seeing it as a good thing, because I have found so much joy in what I've done, and it has brought me so much joy this year, but I'm still not fully supporting myself, so maybe it was a bad thing. I don't know. But anyway, for the sake of this video, I'm choosing to put it as a good thing. So that's the first thing. And then the next really good thing that happened this year was me deciding to stream on Twitch. This one definitely took me by surprise. It was mid-April that I decided to start streaming, mid-April 2021. I had streamed 2 years ago before that point, just playing Sims and other games just for fun. But this time I decided to do it as an artist, primarily. Yeah, and I just dove in, started streaming, and I honestly don't think that my mental health would have been as good as it was in 2021 had I not streamed. I found streaming to be so fulfilling and so comforting. I've never felt closer to you guys than when I had started streaming, and it just brought a whole bunch of positivity and a really cozy, safe space for me and for a lot of you into my life, which I think was really needed. I never really anticipated that my adventures in streaming on Twitch would have led to what it has this year, and I'm really excited that I took that leap, and I'm really excited to see where it leads in 2022. And then the third really good thing that happened this year, I'm kind of lumping like a whole bunch of things in one category, but I'm just gonna call it creative growth. This year, in 2021, I made so much new art, more than I had even realized. I illustrated and painted things that I had never painted before. I did more landscapes than I've ever done. Actually, I don't even know if I had done any landscapes up until this year. I painted animals, where I used to only really draw people or just like really cute little drawings. I really pushed myself creatively. I manufactured my first product for my store. I made washi tape for the first time ever and had that made, shipped to me. That was a whole experience that I'm really proud of myself for doing. I made earrings with polymer clay, which is something that I've wanted to do for years, and I finally made the leap and did it, which was awesome and exciting. So yeah, like when I look back on 2021, even though it feels like it was a year that was full of so much fear and awfulness, there's actually so many really positive things that did happen. And yeah, making this video and writing all of this down, it was just very therapeutic for me to reflect on the good that happened this year. I'm really proud of how I've grown as a creative person this year. But yeah, I think that concludes the good and the bad of 2021. I know I'm forgetting a million things, but this is just what I could think of the other day when I was making these notes. Now I'm just gonna take a really tiny moment to talk about my goals for 2022. I don't know if you guys have seen that like meme video of Pete Davidson where somebody asks him what he wants to do in 2022, and he's like, I'm not gonna make any resolutions because I don't wanna disappoint myself. That's kind of where I'm at. I don't wanna make any goals that are too concrete. I don't wanna make goals that have anything to do with numbers. I don't wanna put any pressure on myself. I still feel like I'm recovering from 2021, as I'm sure many of you can relate to that. So I just wanna be really gentle with myself going into 2022. I want to focus on doing things that make me feel good and make me feel happy. And so I'm gonna try to do that. I know that there's a couple things I learned over the past year that do make me feel good, and that's having a good sleeping schedule. I feel better when I wake up earlier in the morning and can get my day started when the sun is up. And especially this time of year when the days are pretty short. Taking advantage of daylight is really important to me. So that's one thing I want to continue doing in 2022. I want to put good food into my body. I want to try to exercise a little bit, not for any like weight goals or anything like that. No, that's toxic. I just want to do it to keep my mental health good and to feel good. Yeah, so those are some of my goals. I have some other random goals as well. Like, for example, I want to try making sourdough bread and I want to make kombucha. And I started brewing my first batch of kombucha, so I've already started on that. Sourdough was freaking intimidating, but I'm doing some research into that. But yeah, other than that, I just want to continue moving in a direction. I'm not even gonna say moving forward because I don't even know what forward is right now. I just want to keep moving in a direction, keep doing what I love, and honestly just try to create a safe, cozy environment on all of my platforms for people who are struggling right now, because I know that there's a lot of them. So anyway, I'm not gonna ramble on any longer, but thank you so much for watching this video. I love you guys so much. I had such a great year with you in 2021, and I'm really excited to move into 2022 with you all. So I'll see you guys really soon. Bye!